Hello, God bless you. I hope everyone is having a great day. This is Brother David. I want to bring in a beautiful scripture found in the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verse 4, which says, "In him was life, and the life was the light of men." This is such a beautiful scripture. We have in the description box a little bit more information if you want to dive a little deeper in the scripture. It's such a beautiful promise here. See, verse 4, this life means power to exist. In Genesis 2:7, we read how God had given life to men. The Lord God formed man out of the dust of the ground and breathed life into his nostrils, the breath of life. And man became a living soul. Man was but clay until the breath of life was breathed into it. Then he became alive. The word Jesus made him alive. This light gives everything the power to be. If a man receives this light, it gives them the power to receive eternal life. Life and light are qualities of the Word that are shared not only among the Godhead, but also by those who respond to the gospel message. Life refers not only to physical and temporal life that the Son imparted on the created world through his involvement in creation, but especially to spiritual and eternal life imparted as a gift through belief in himself. So when we believe in Jesus, we have this life that he's talking about. In scripture, light and darkness are very familiar symbols. Light refers to biblical truth, holiness, purity. Darkness refers to error, falsehood, sin, and wrongdoing. Darkness has a special significance in relationship to Satan and his demons, who rule the present spiritually dark world as the prince of the power of the air, promoting spiritual darkness and rebellion against God. Light and life have their specific, special significance in relationship to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Word of God. This verse proclaims Jesus' role as the giver of eternal life. This verse also refers to Jesus using the second name for Jesus of the seven that John uses, this being the light, first being the word. To a Hebrew, light was an ultimate value. All good things were said to be of the light, and all evil things was darkness. Light implies a revealing. Jesus not only exposes our sinfulness, he illuminates a way to be saved from it. Light implies knowledge and awareness, while darkness is ignorance. For some, darkness is a deliberate choice. They know what they do is wrong, but they prefer to hide from the truth. Light guides and comforts, but light also infuriates those who want to stay in darkness. This light is specifically for mankind. In John 8:12, Jesus says that he is the light of the world. God created everything by means of the word Jesus. This means that Jesus caused everything to exist. He gave life to everything that was created. Life does not mean the period between birth and death. It does not mean just to have a physical body that is alive. It means that our spirits become alive too. Life is opposite of death. When we believe in Jesus as our Lord and Savior, he gives us eternal life. Jesus lives in us now by means of the Holy Spirit. When we die, we will not be separated from him. We have eternal life. This means that we live with him in heaven. But we must understand what it means to believe in Jesus as our Lord and Savior. We must believe that Jesus is God's Son. We must obey him. We must believe that he died on our behalf. All of us deserve a punishment because of our sin, but Jesus took the punishment instead of us. We must confess our sins to God, and when we believe all this, then we have eternal life. We need the light to see our physical surroundings. Light shows us what things are really like. But in this verse, it's not talking about physical light that comes from the sun. This verse is about spiritual light. This spiritual light shows what we are really like. We have all done wrong, but Jesus, who is the light of the world, shows us how to live. We need to follow the light. This means that we must let Jesus guide us. So for those of you who don't know Jesus today, I want to share the gospel because we want you to be guided by the light. Because when you were apart from Jesus, it's like walking in the dark. And you know, with modern technology, with street lamps and things, the best way I can think to describe it is like going in the woods, where the trees are so thick you can't see the moon and the stars. Well, there's no street lamps. There's places where when it's night, there's no light and it is just complete blackness. And that's what it's like living apart from Jesus. And we want you to live in the light that gives life. Because you may intellectually know who Jesus is. You may know what he did on the cross, but you don't know him personally. You don't take the time to talk to him, to pray to him, to get to know him, to read the Bible. I want to introduce you to Jesus today. The gospel message in a nutshell is that because of the fall from Genesis chapter 3, sin entered the world. Sin creates a wall that separates all of us from God. Romans 3:23 confirms this, saying that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 6:23 says the wages of sin is death, meaning that because of our sin, not one of us is worthy of going to heaven. But as we see in John 3:16, God loves you so much that God the Son Jesus left heaven, became a flesh and blood human, fully God, fully man. 2 Corinthians 5:21 says, Jesus lived a perfect sinless life, but on the cross Jesus became sin for us to pay our sins. Meaning when Jesus was on the cross, Jesus put on our sin so that when we believe the gospel message and are saved, then we put on his righteousness. And now when God looks at us, he doesn't see our sin. Now God sees Jesus. The gospel message is 1 Corinthians 15, 1-4. Jesus died for our sins and was buried, rose again from the dead on the third day, according to the scriptures. Romans 10, 9, if you confess Jesus with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, then you'll be saved. And as we see at the end of John 3:16, whoever believes in Jesus will have eternal life. Romans 10:13 says it this way, for whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Jesus says in John 14:6 that he is the only way to heaven. Jesus' blood is what bought our ticket into heaven. Jesus' blood is the ticket. Jesus' blood is what covered our sin debt, past, present, and future. Jesus' blood is what broke down the wall that separates us from God. So if you sincerely believe and surrender your life to Jesus, meaning you're not just saying words to try to please someone or get a get out of hell free card, but you really believe in what Jesus did on the cross and you truly want to live for him now, then you'll be saved. This is Jesus' free gift to you, and all you have to do is accept it. Because we can't earn our way to heaven. We can't do enough good deeds. We can't be enough good enough person. And when you stand before God, it won't matter how much you've given to charity or that you think that you're a good person, that you never robbed or killed anybody. Our works, our deeds are not good enough to get us into heaven. Ephesians 2:8-9 says it's by grace that we are saved through faith. Not of ourselves, it's a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Meaning, we can't earn it, we don't deserve it, but God loves us enough that he made a way. That light shined to make a way. And we always follow the gospel, the warning of Jesus is in my return. Because right now you can personally know Jesus, but one day soon and how soon, we don't know. But complete hell on earth will come. We can see it coming. The world's getting darker by the minute. The Bible predicts that the shadow of the tribulation is so big right now, we can barely see light around it. And one day soon, the restrainer who is holding hell back will be removed. Then the tribulation will begin. It will be a time of terrifying supernatural events. Scarier than any movie you've seen or nightmare you ever had. Each day will get progressively worse. It'll be literal hell on earth. Some signs look for the tribulation or someone will rise to power. With all the answers, simply put, he's a dictator empowered by Satan, and he'll rule the whole world and set up a one world government, one world currency, and one world religion. In this satanic system, you can't buy, sell, or eat unless you're part of the system. And he will confirm a worldwide peace deal that will allow Israel to build their third temple. And when Israel gets their ashes of the red heifer, which purifies them to offer sacrifices, then they will start their daily sacrifices. And we know that at the midway point, the Antichrist will stop the daily sacrifices. In the tribulation, there may be some sort of global social credit system set up where if you're good this week, you can buy you a burger, whatever it may be. But right now, we can still freely buy, sell, or eat whatever we want. But the freedom to jump in the car and go get whatever you want, soon that time will be over. Soon we'll see Israel offering their daily sacrifices. But until we see this, we're not in the tribulation yet. But it is coming. Bible prophecy is jumping off the page. And I want you to know Jesus personally before all hell breaks loose. Because right now, before the tribulation starts, we're under the age of grace. And that right now is the easy way out to come to Jesus. All you have to do is sincerely believe in what Jesus did for on the cross and surrender your life to him. Accept Jesus' free gift, that free ticket into heaven. But after the tribulation begins, the age of grace will be over. And that'll be the hard way, and you'll have to do more than just believe in Jesus. You'll have to die for Jesus. But I love you, and I don't want that for you. So right now, before the age of grace is over, accept this light that God is offering you. Please turn to Jesus today. We believe that one day millions will disappear along with all the children all over the world. And when you hear that all these have vanished, you know that no matter what may be said, because based on what we're seeing, they may use aliens to explain away what happened, but no, if you don't see me or hear my voice, if these videos are not uploaded, if all the children around the world are gone along with millions of others, know that Jesus took us home in the rapture. Many have different opinions on the rapture. We're not here to argue about the timing or the reality of the rapture. These theologies really don't matter. One thing is for sure, the Bible's clear. We're not guaranteed tomorrow. We're not guaranteed our next breath. And even if we are here to see some of the hell that's coming, who knows how long we'll survive. But the end is here. So if you don't know Jesus today, please take the time to get to know him while you still have the time. So whatever excuse you may be telling yourself right now, don't put Jesus off. We're not guaranteed our next breath. There's no guarantee you'll live to see the sunrise tomorrow. Today is the day of salvation. In the description box, we have a link to the ABCs of Salvation as well as a simple prayer. These are just templates and outline of what you can say. It's not a repeat after me. There's no magic words. The words are not important. It just needs to be a sincere prayer from your heart that you can't do this on your own, that you need a Savior. Pray you got something out of this. Don't take my word for it. No one on this earth has the answers you're looking for. Only God does, and you'll only receive your answers through prayer and by reading the Bible. It's so very important to read the Bible for yourself. Just picking random verses or listening to someone read or preach for a few minutes, you're not going to get the full picture. They can't even scratch the surface of what's inside the Bible. So read and discover the stories for yourself. The Bible will strengthen you and help you to face any and every trial, tribulation, temptation, or struggle you may be going through right now. In the description box, we have several sources to help you read the Bible, also an audio Bible. If you don't have a physical book, and if you don't believe in Jesus today, tell him you don't believe in him. Ask Jesus to prove himself to you today, but be open to accept his answer. And if you need prayer or have a praise report, please reach out to us. We want to stand in agreement with you in your prayer. And we want to praise Jesus right along with you for what he's doing in your life. I pray you got something out of the video today. If you did, give God glory. I cannot wait to see the Lord has for us tomorrow. We'll see you tomorrow or in the clouds.